the Bergfleet Pass lies on the tarred R536 route between Hazyview and Sabi on the eastern side of the Mpumalanga province. Named after the Bergfleet plantation through which it traverses, this pass forms the most curvy and scenic part of the infamous 22. The stretch of road between Sabi and Kippersol turnoff is 22 kilometers long, hence the name, and it's acknowledged as being one of the best motorcycling roads in South Africa, if not the world. The regional authorities are well aware of this, and the road surface is maintained in a pristine condition in stark contrast to the other half of the R536 on the Hazyview side and the Kippersol road, which are riddled with potholes and broken tar. If you're driving this route in a car, buggy or SUV, pay close attention and be on the lookout for motorcycles which could encroach onto the wrong side of the road on any day of the week. We filmed this pass from east to west. It starts off 4.4 kilometers from the Kippersol turn-off en route to Sabi. The road twists and turns, climbing at a gentle gradient through lush vegetation on both sides. Stands of tall pine trees are interspersed with farms and homesteads, offering magnificent views of the mountains and the Sabi River, which the pass tracks for its entire length. The road dips down occasionally, but generally speaking it climbs slowly upwards for 196 vertical meters to reach its maximum altitude of 996 meters at the summit, which occurs on the apex of a big 180 degree hairpin bend at the 5.4 kilometer point. The road is in an excellent condition, with even corners and positive banking in all the right places. If you're riding a motorcycle, be particularly vigilant and wary of the sand patches which occur wherever any of the numerous side roads intersect with the tar. Logging vehicles can also appear at any time and can occasionally lose part of their load, so watch out for this as well. There are very few straight sections, seldom for longer than 200 meters, so driving this pass requires intense concentration and awareness. The descent follows a pattern very similar to the ascent, as the road snakes down towards the valley floor, but the gradient is fairly gentle. It's difficult to ascertain the extent of each corner, as your view is usually blocked by vegetation, so travel at a reasonable and constant speed and be prepared to brake when necessary. The winding roads in the mountains of Mpumalanga have always traditionally been known as bikers' paradise. Commonly referred to as ET, an acronym for Eastern Transvaal, the sweeping bends, corners and curves lend themselves fully to the magic of motorcycling, whether you enjoy cruising along slowly with the wind in your face or the white-knuckle, foot-back-scraping adrenaline rush of a high-speed run. Unfortunately, many of the roads have fallen into a state of disrepair and are plagued by potholes. In the period leading up to the 2010 Soccer World Cup, the authorities made an all-out effort to keep the roads in tip-top condition, but this is no longer the case. The biggest culprits which have caused this havoc are the heavily laden mining trucks and logging vehicles which ply many of the routes in this area, and some roads have become an absolute nightmare and are downright dangerous to drive. This has, without question, had an impact on tourism in the region, bearing in mind that most of the routes heading towards the Kruger National Park run through this area. The most famous stretch of road for motorcyclists is known as the 22, also sometimes called the infamous 22, on the R536 between Sabi and the Kippersol turnoff. An accurate measurement of the road reveals that it's actually 21.7 kilometers long, but nobody is too concerned about the 300 meter difference. There are 66 corners on this run, and many of these have been given names such as Kawasaki Corner, the Bowl, Baboon Alley and the Chicane. A major feature of this road is the fact that all of the corners have a set radius, meaning that the angle through the turn never changes and riders can commit to a line in the sure knowledge that it will not suddenly tighten up. Always remember that this is a public road and it does traverse a working logging plantation, so always be on the lookout for hazards such as rubble, logs, dirt, diesel spills and slow-moving or even stationary vehicles. The town of Sabi is located right in the heart of ET, nestled in a deep valley on the escarpment of the Drakensberg Mountains. The road flattens out as it approaches the bottom of the pass at the 9.2 kilometer mark, and the valley widens as you meet up with the river. Continue straight onwards for another 8.1 kilometers to reach the town of Sabi. ¶¶